how much money you need to invest to rely only on dividends for income, having explored various avenues for passive income, be it side gigs, real estate ventures, or online marketing programs, I found dividends to be surprisingly accessible for replacing income without needing hefty investments. But before we dive in, there is a caveat I would like to address. It's crucial to weigh the pros and cons of dividend investing to see if it aligns with your financial goals. I will share my insights on whether diving into dividend investing is worthwhile and discuss realistic investment goals. Before we dive in, let's highlight one of the perks of dividends, an example of their passive nature. Just like subscribing, dividends offer a hands-off way to grow your wealth. Speaking of which, if you haven't subscribed yet, it's easy as a click, granting you access to new videos every week. As a token of gratitude for your support, I will make it a priority to respond to as many comments as I can. Now, let's get back to the basics. When you purchase a stock, you essentially become a part owner of that company. This ownership entitles you to a share of the company's profits. Sometimes, these profits are distributed regularly to shareholders in the form of dividends. Dividends are a fixed amount paid out for each share you own, usually on a quarterly basis. The percentage of this dividend is calculated based on the current trading price of the stock. Imagine you own a share that pays you $5 each year, and the current price for that share is $100. That means you are getting a 5% return on your investment annually. However, this return can change depending on how much the share is worth at any given time. Not every company chooses to pay out dividends. They might believe they can achieve better returns by reinvesting their profits into their business. But when companies do pay dividends, they typically range from 1 to 10% of the share price. This makes dividends an attractive option for generating passive income, offering a relatively straightforward way to earn money without actively working for it. From an investment perspective, dividends provide a steady stream of cash flow without requiring you to sell any of your shares. This leaves you with more capital to invest in other opportunities, like perhaps acquiring intriguing items such as 1934 $500 bill. However, like any investment strategy, there are both advantages and disadvantages to consider. As for my personal approach to replacing income, here's where I stand to begin with. Looking at the broader picture, one of the great things about dividends is very relative stability compared to market fluctuations. Even during those times, like we've experienced over the past year, dividends tend to remain more consistent. Regardless of whether a stock's price is trading at $20 or $40, you can generally count on receiving the same dividend payment. This predictability offers a sense of security amidst the ups and downs of the market. Second, dividend payments are also a lot less volatile than stock prices. For example, the Simply Safe Dividends blog pointed out that from 1900 through 2018, dividend payments remain fairly constant with an average variance of plus or minus 10 during market downturns. It also helps that dividend companies tend to be a lot more mature and prioritize stability. Another advantage of investing in dividend-paying stocks is their resilience during economic downturns. Interestingly, historical data highlighted by the Simply Safe Dividends blog reveals that in certain recessions, dividends actually increased. For instance, following World War II, there was a notable 46% uptick in dividends during the initial recession. While such increases aren't guaranteed with every downturn, statistics show that, on average, dividend cuts are minimal, around 0.5%, in contrast to the stock market's substantial average decline of 32%. Moreover, dividend stocks have demonstrated their ability to deliver returns comparable to the broader market. This suggests that investors can potentially achieve solid investment gains while also benefiting from steady dividend income. If you found any value so far, please like and subscribe. Determining your needs to live a financially free life ultimately boils down to your lifestyle preferences. The expenses of someone residing in a luxurious penthouse in New York City vastly differ from those of an individual living off the grid in a tiny home in Montana. Therefore, it's essential to align your investment goals with your specific expenses. For the sake of illustration, Let's consider the average retiree expenditure of $50,000 annually as our benchmark. When it comes to dividend investing, chasing the highest yield isn't always the wisest strategy. Consistency is a key. This brings us to the pinnacle of passive income, dividend aristocrats. The dividend aristocrats represent a distinguished group of 65 companies within the S&P 500 index. What sets them apart is the remarkable track record of increasing dividends consecutively for over 25 years. These companies are meticulously chosen based on their size, growth trajectory, and their proven ability to sustain and elevate dividend payments over time. Remarkably, over the past two decades, the dividend aristocrats have demonstrated exceptional resilience with only 2 years of negative growth, 2008 and 2018. Their consistent performance has consistently surpassed market averages, primarily due to their unwavering reliability. Furthermore, during periods of economic downturns, many of these companies have shown remarkable resilience. While they may experience declines along with the broader market, they tend to endure these downturns far more gracefully, often outperforming other stocks. The resilience of dividend-paying companies, particularly the dividend aristocrats, can be attributed to their emphasis on cash flow management, prudent spending practices, and commitment to rewarding shareholders. As a result, these companies typically offer dividend yields ranging from 0.3% to 5.3%, with the majority falling between 2 and 3%. To illustrate, let's consider an average yield of 3%. If you aim to replace a yearly income of $50,000, you would need approximately $1,670,000 invested in a basket of these stocks. Breaking it down further, achieving this goal is feasible by investing $5,000 annually over a period of 40 years while reinvesting the dividends. Voila! You've successfully replaced your annual income through prudent dividend investing. If you're like me and prefer quicker results, there are other methods to achieve your financial goals. One such approach gaining popularity is investing in covered call ETFs like JEPI. These funds generate income by selling options while also investing in US large cap stocks. What's enticing about this strategy is the potential income it offers, up to 10.7% to be precise. Essentially, this fund provides a steady yield irrespective of market performance, as it pays investors based on the premiums of the call options it sells on its holdings. It's a compelling option for those seeking consistent income in a potentially volatile market. It's important to recognize that while covered call ETFs offer steady income, they come with trade-offs. One significant drawback is the limited potential for upside gains if the market performs well. Additionally, if the market experiences a downturn, the fund's price will likely decline accordingly. In essence, there is no free lunch in investing. However, this approach does not present an intriguing opportunity. Hypothetically, by investing $500,000 in such a fund, you could potentially replace a $50,000 yearly income. This figure is much more attainable for the average American investor, offering a realistic pathway to financial stability and passive income. While covered call ETFs offer an attractive option for generating immediate income, it's crucial to exercise caution. Putting all your investments into such a fund isn't advisable because their primary objective is a short-term income generation. Over the long term, you are likely to see significantly lower returns compared to the overall market, or even risk losing a portion of your initial investment capital. Diversification and balanced approach to investing remain key principles for sustainable financial growth and wealth preservation. So, dividends aren't just about making more money. They also offer a sense of security. Imagine getting a regular paycheck without having to sell any of your investments. That's what dividends do. Even if you don't need the money right away, it's nice to know it's there if you ever do. Plus, it's like a little bonus for being a patient investor. While dividends are a great part of a balanced investment plan, if you are young and don't need the cash now, it's okay to focus on other types of investments. The key is finding what works best for you and your goals. So, that's it for today. Now that you know some basics of dividend investing, I would suggest you to watch a video next about 4 dividend ETFs that will crush a CHD. It's a video I recently made and it will be linked down below. If you found this video meaningful and informative, feel free to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. We will be thankful to you. See you in the next one.